The Abuko Nature Reserve is one of the most popular tourist attractions in the country, situated on the frontier separating Abuko in the Kanifi municipality and Lamin in the West Coast region. It was established in 1968 as a sanctuary for plants and animals. However, the history of this reserve stretches back to 1916, when the colonial authorities built a major water pumping station to supply the capital Bathurst, now Banjul and Fajara.
It was from here, through Abuko, then to Joshuan, Old Joshuan, then cross the bridge, then to Banjul, at the Albion Park. So that was how exactly, and then like the operations was being done. So these are the remains of the machines that you can, but they were being used to pump water to Banjul.
By virtue of its strategic location, Lamin had all the ingredients required for the supply of fresh water to the colonial capital, which was struggling to provide water to its residents. Therefore, after careful studies, the then colonial governor, Sir Galloway, ordered the construction of a water pumping system to tap the rich water resources available.
So it's a catchment area. Mm-hmm. Lamin is virtually sloppy. Mm-hmm. So all the rainwater that used to come, from the village and its surroundings, mm-hmm. ends up here. Yeah. It ends up here. So it becomes a very huge stream. Then the sediment settled down, other reptiles came in, and so on and so forth.
History has it that the water pumping system could not fulfill its purpose initially, a situation that was in the water crisis in Bathurst. The colonialists did not reckon that the area was possessed by a dragon, which nullified any attempts to get the machinery working. It was not until one man intervened that things started working, much to the respite of the colonial authorities and their suffering subjects.
My grandfather suddenly came. No, we talked to one of the technicians there, the mechanics, that, well, if you can give me the opportunity, now if you can talk to the white man to give me the opportunity, I think I can put the machine on. Looking at him, gazing at him, they said, look, who the hell you think you are? We don't know you. You said this is, you can do this. He said, well, I'm just asking you, to give me the permission to do it. If I don't do it, then that's it. But I think I can do it. Then he went inside. I don't think we'll get to that place. Okay. He went inside the engine room, mm-hmm. traced all the sources where the water used to come from, the pumps and everything.
Baba Jinde is a grandson of the late Baba Jinde Senior, who through his mystical faculties was able to banish the dragon, whose migration into the unknown left a trail of destruction. This story of the dragon has been written by a French tourist who told of the death of Baba Jinde at the hands of this terrible creature, furious that he had betrayed his secrets to the white man. This version, according to his grandson, is totally untrue.
I personally would not buy that story, because this is a white lady who comes all the way from France, doesn't know anything about Africa, especially the Gambia, and then happens to come here on vacation and decided to write something about the Gambia. So these are some of the stories that they do capture. And actually, if you don't get to the source of the story, you cannot authenticate it. Some portion of it is authenticated, but then that portion of saying that because my grandfather betrayed the dragon and then the dragon ended up killing him, no, because this happened in 1918. This place was opened in 1916. My grandfather started working here in 1916. In 1918-1919, that was when he facilitated the migration of the Minkinanga. And whilst on his flight to the sea, it crossed the bridge that was here first. Then my grandfather died later, after 22 years.
But whatever it is, the Abuko Nature Reserve occupies a unique place in the Gambia's socio-political history. Banjul has now moved on a century later into a proud city, where access to clean drinking water may be taken for granted. But 100 years back, it took one man to save the city from an angry dragon who would not allow the colonialists to desecrate its sacred sanctuary. Mamoudou Diallo, GRTS News.